Hello friends, welcome to Technical and Programming IQ. This is our second video in the C programming tutorial. In the previous video, I had shown how to install code blocks and also executed one basic program. So that I will explain now. Just open the code blocks. Search for the code blocks and press enter. I will open an existing project because I have a basic program. This is it. If you are making new project, then click on create a new project and choose C and go on just go on clicking on next. So this is the basic program of displaying the name or anything you want to display. So here are some files. Here is a big code, means the function we are printing, according to it the code is very big. So once again I will execute it. So this is what it gets executed. So whatever we have written in this is displayed here. So the basic of C is that C was invented by Dennis Ritchie at AT&T Bell Labs, and he made Unix with the help of C programming. So C is used for many functions nowadays, for making applications in many companies. So now we will start with the C programming. So this is the basic header file. This both line of code are actually some file located at some location. These are called as header files, and for including the header file, we should write hash include stdio.h. So what does it mean? Stdio.h means standard input output, and stdlib means standard library. So by including these files, we are giving some location of the function which we are using below. Int means a empty loop. So this is actually an empty loop. Int main. We can also use void main, but here we are using int main. And printf means print function. So here we are printing welcome. So you can print your name and execute it, and after that there is a semicolon, which is very necessary. You should never forget to type a semicolon after a program. And then the last one is the return zero. So return zero specifies that as this is an empty loop, after executing the function, return zero value, so that it will get terminated. And these two curly brackets are very necessary. That this means that the program is in between these curly brackets, and after the execution you will get this. So this is the basic of C, and here we can also use getch in Turbo C++, which is another application for writing C codes. Many of the people use that also. In that case, here it is getch, but also it needs to include hash include conio.h, which means the console input output at h. But for now, we are using a return zero for this, and this is it for today. For next video, stay tuned and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Technical and Programming TK. And don't forget to press the bell icon for our next video in the C programming tutorials.